Welcome to the chess video, guys. So the clip you're seeing right now is actually from the summer when I was at Alpha Elite Gym. And I just want to point something out before we get into five exercises I almost guarantee you guys have never seen in your life for chest. Now, the chest has muscle fibers going in three different directions. So I know it just looks like the chest is kind of one giant plate of armor looking muscle, but you have muscle fibers going in three different directions, and that's why it is so important to do different exercises to hit different parts of the chest. So let's get right into the workout.
You ain't got no gains. You ain't lift no weights.
Welcome to my gym, guys. So the reason that I think it's so important to show you guys exercises you've probably never seen before is motivation and getting past a plateau. I know nothing excites me more than trying new exercises, stepping foot in the gym, and doing exercises that I've never done before. And I know that you guys are gonna find some of these are gonna really work well for you, maybe some of them don't. But I know the more unique exercises I throw at you, the better results you're gonna have. So what you see me actually doing here now is I'm doing a quick little calf warm-up. I'm trying to do 5 to 7 sets, 4 to 5 times a week of abs and calves to bring up those weak points. Now let's get into these five unique chest exercises. The first chest exercise you've never seen is the floor cable fly. Now I know 99% of guys typically do the cable fly machine standing up. Doing it on the floor eliminates momentum from every other muscle group, so you really can't cheat this movement. Now you wanna start off with your hand position just above waist height. And this one is going to work the mid chest. It's also going to work the lower chest. So this one is a great mass builder. And challenge yourself, but don't go too heavy on this. Really focus on squeezing the chest, going nice and slow and controlled. And I recommend 3 total sets in the 10 to 12 rep range. And really focus on going back down on the eccentric portion to a count of 2 seconds and then exploding up. Next chest exercise you've never seen is awesome for working the lower chest. And I'm really trying to work on my lower chest. I noticed that just looking at my chest aesthetically, I feel underdeveloped in my lower chest. Now, underhand push-ups on dumbbells with your feet elevated. Now notice my hand positions. It's angled inward, but I have an underhand grip position on the dumbbells. Now this one really allows you, it's almost like I found it easier to contract and squeeze where I felt the contraction more in the lower part of my chest than even weighted dips on this. So I really enjoyed this exercise. Focus on squeezing and contracting the chest muscle. Instead of just focusing on getting as many reps as possible, I want you guys to focus on squeezing the pec muscle throughout each and every single repetition on this. Focus on my muscle connection in a What I like to tell myself during each rep is how can I make this rep harder on the muscle? So this is a great exercise to go nice and slow and controlled, challenge yourself, and I want you guys to go 15 to 20 reps until failure. Exercise number 3 for the chest that you have not seen before is the Smith Machine Hex Press. Now, this movement was a little tricky to get into position. You're gonna need a V-bar extension. So the V-bar is typically the extension that you would use on the seated row machine. Now the key for this exercise is I want you to think of squeezing the V-bar, like think of squeezing it and bending it inward. So you're pushing in, so your hands are facing each other, parallel grip, and you're focusing on squeezing that bar as hard as you can to contract your chest. So your chest should be fully activated before you even start the first repetition. So start off by squeezing that bar inward with a parallel grip as hard as you can, and then you're gonna go down nice and slow and controlled, trying to contract your chest. Now this exercise reminds me a little bit of a landmine press, and I really liked it on the Smith machine. So the Smith machine allows you to kind of keep it stable and really focus on your chest contractions and your mind-muscle connection. So with this one, don't go too heavy, focus on your form. I want you guys to go 3 total sets in the 8 to 12 repetition range. Next exercise, we have the incline dumbbell hex press. Now, once again, this is gonna work the upper chest. We're gonna have the seat position at an incline. And once again, you're focusing on squeezing your hands together to contract your chest. So it's not just moving the weight up and down on this. What makes this really difficult and what gives it great mass building potential for your chest is you're working your chest as you're squeezing your hands together. Like I'm doing this right now, I'm focusing on contracting and squeezing. And then I'm also going up and down with resistance. So it's a really unique movement because you have resistance while you're going up and down on the eccentric and concentric portion of each rep. And you're also contracting your chest by squeezing your hands together while you're holding that single dumbbell. So go light on this, really make sure you got your form down. And I want you guys to go 3 total sets in the 10 to 12 repetition range. This is one of my favorite upper chest finishers. The last exercise is the decline bench underhand dumbbell fly. So this is an awesome exercise to work the lower chest, also hit the mid chest. So you wanna make sure that your hands are in an underhand grip position. Now you're focusing once again on mind muscle connection, and the easiest way to ensure that you're working your chest properly on this is count to 2 or 3 seconds on the way back down. So you should be able to keep tension right on your pectoral muscles as you lower the weight on the eccentric portion. If you go too fast and you just kind of like lower the weight quickly, not only can you risk injury on this exercise, but you're taking tension directly off of the muscle, because remember, it's on the eccentric portion of each repetition where we actually build muscle. So if you're a natural bodybuilder, you're trying to build your muscle naturally, it is so important that you realize that important detail. So on this exercise, once again, 3 total sets in the 8 to 10 rep range. So this is going to be a part of an entire series where I'm going to go through every single muscle group, and I'm going to share 5 to 7 outside the box exercises that I almost guarantee you've never tried. So I did the shoulder one yesterday. I'm going to link to that in the description below. Make sure you guys check that out if you haven't already. Now, why I think this is so important is the number one way to burst through any plateau, whether it be mental or physical, if you're losing motivation, is to try new exercises. I know everyone's body is different. People have short arms, long arms. Some of you guys are really short. Some of you guys are really tall. And different exercises are going to activate your chest and different muscle groups differently for everybody. So I think the more exercises that you guys try, the more that you're gonna find really work for you. And I know nothing gets me more excited than going in the gym and trying new exercises. So thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you hit the like button. Let me know what you thought of the video in the comments below. And let me know what muscle group you want to see next in the series.
You ain't got no gains. You ain't left no weights.